Hello and welcome back to jQuery for Designers. My name is Remy Sharp and I'm wearing a hat because my hair is insane. Anyway, in this episode what I want to show you is how to populate a select box based on another select box input. And it's really, really simple. It's one of those things that come up on the web all the time. I've even written an article a long while ago how to do it, and it's probably a little more complicated than it needs to be, and I want to show you a really simple way of doing this. And it's also very easy for prototypes, so it's worth having a look at. So here's my simple page. Actually, that's where I want to get to. So where we've got this select box, I've populated it, but let's go to the source code. It's here. So this is the starting point. Let's get rid of this. That's the actual starting point. We've got a select box that says medium and easy and so on. You click on it. When you hit next, imagine that this is hooked up to an actual server and it pulls back the category results. That's how we want it to work without JavaScript. Now with JavaScript, we want to make it work so that when we select the category, hit next, we then get that second select box like you saw here. I'll actually get rid of this next button. And then when they select an article, they hit read. Now, caveat, this is not a way to do navigation. This is just an example that I've pulled out of my own website where I've got categories and items in that category. You see this kind of thing being used in registration forms where they're selecting the country and then maybe the city or the nearest city. Or on eBay where they're selecting the category and subcategory and subcategory and so on. So I just want to show you how to do that. So the first thing I need to do is have on my server side or somewhere else the Ajax responder. So what we're going to do is we're going to select an item from here and I'm going to say go and find me all of the articles that match the hard category. And what we're going to respond with is the HTML to create this select box, so basically everything in this option list. So I've got these already created here. I've got one for medium, easy, and hard. I've just hard coded these. So easy, medium, and hard. And you can see, let's just have a look at these one by themselves. All it is an option, as in it's one option from a select box where it has the value, which is an href in this case, so we're just going to maybe go off to that URL, and some text. Pretty straightforward. I've hard-coded these. This is useful for a prototype. So if you were prototyping this, doing a prototype and showing it to a client, you could just hard-code these. And then once the server guys come in, they would actually be hitting a database or doing something else. So those are my files, these three files. And let's go back to my actual script here. I've got my copy of jQuery loaded in, 1.5's current latest version. And this is the markup I want to get to, but this is where we're starting from. So let's comment this out. Now down here, we could do document.ready function, off we go. But because the JavaScript is at the bottom of the document, we don't have to do that. That's just a tip for you, I guess. Right, so first things first, we want to make an Ajax request when the form is submitted. So let's do that. Let's do form.submit and we're going to do capture the event. So there's a variable that comes into the submit callback and we're going to do event.prevent default. And what that does is stop the form from actually being submitted. So if we I've saved that, let's just refresh that. Click next, nothing's happening, you see, because we're preventing default. Okay, so let's make the Ajax request. Now, the Ajax request is going to be the URL that is select boxes dash, and then it's the category name, so category name plus .html. That's the URL we need to make a request for. Now, there's a bunch of different ways of doing Ajax-based requests. I'm just, maybe, categorized into Ajax in the documentation. Shorthand methods. These are the ones that we want to look at. This is the one I want to use, dot load. Okay, and the way that dot load works, and I've got a screencast on this as well, it literally takes the contents of an Ajax request and takes all of that content, just puts it straight into that element that you ran the selector on. So it's as if you're just inserting HTML. So let's do, let's, for this part of the demo, create the select box, name equals article, ID equals article. Let's do $article.load, and then we give it the URL. URL data, we don't need any of the other stuff, just the URL. So let's put that straight in. Now we haven't got category name, but that's easy to get. So var category name equals, and that is equal to whatever the value of this category drop down select box is. So let's do $category.val. And let's try that. So I've put in an empty select box to start off with. Hit refresh. Okay, we've got our empty select box here. Let's do hard. Click on next. Okay, let's go over to the file and double check that those are the items. So infinite carousel. Cool. Let's change that to easy. Next. Cool. So that, you see that the way that works. If we just open the web inspector, look at the HTML, you can see inside here we've got those options. Really, really straightforward. That's a really easy way of dynamically populating a second select box using jQuery. I mean, that's literally all there is. I've given it a URL. That URL returns the option elements and it goes straight into our new select box. Now, if you want, we could end it here, but what I'd like to do is actually take it a little bit further and create the select box on the fly, create a new submit button that says read, and kind of progressively enhance the page. So let's get rid of the select box. And what we're going to do is, we need to say if the select box, so the category, so we're going to create a variable called category, which is the category element. Now I've put dollar in front of it because it tells me that it has the same, the variable name has the same ID as the actual select box element. But by putting a dollar in front of it, it tells me as a developer that this is a variable that is jQueryified, so I can do dot click, dot submit, and so on. So I've captured that variable, and I want to say when the category is changed, so on change, run this function. And the function will be go and do the Ajax request, so let's copy that in. Notice we've already done this selector, so we don't have to do it again. We can just change it to category. Okay. Oop. And this element here, article, doesn't exist. So let's say for the first time we do this, we're going to create the article select box. So I'm going to create a variable called article and set it to empty. And I'm going to say if $article is equal to null, I put 3 here, which means absolute, well, effectively means absolutely equal. You can do 2 as well if you wanted to in this particular case. If there's no value to our article, we're going to create it. So we're going to do article equals dollar, select, ID equals article, name equals article, because we want to still post off to the server. And we're going to append to the form. So let's change this to the variable. Let's comment all of this out. So what I'm doing here is I'm saying the first time that we change the category dropdown, create the new select box and append it to the form. So insert after this next button. And the second time it comes around, because article has a value, it doesn't do this again and it just loads it. So let's give that another try. So let's do hard. easy, medium, cool, that works. Problem is this next button is going to submit the form, so we want to get rid of that as well. Let's change the next button. So next, I think I've got an ID. No, I don't. ID equals next. Let's change next from a submit type to button. Now, what we're doing here is we're changing this from submit to a button, not a bottom, so that it doesn't submit the form anymore. But if we run this, it still submits the form. That's because there is a bug in jQuery. So there is a bug right here. I've filed the bug and hopefully they'll fix it. So instead of using ATTR, we're going to do it slightly differently. We're going to get the next element. So we'll do var.next equals this. Okay. And I'm going to do, let's try removing the attribute, remove ATTR type, and then let's try to set the attribute there. This may still not work. Let's open up the error, the web inspector. Okay, that still fails. That's not useful. So that still fails. What I'm going to do is go to the raw DOM nodes, the actual DOM element. At this point, it's wrapped with jQuery. If I do this syntax, so if I show you $next, it's because it's private. Let's just run a selector so I show you in so I can debug it in front of you. So I'm running $next, and if I do square bracket 0, I get the raw DOM node. So you see before it was wrapped in these square brackets. This is the jQuery version of it, and using these square brackets is the actual raw DOM element. So it's the same as doing the vanilla get element by ID next. Exactly the same. So we're going to do that instead. We're going to do modify the element using set attributes type button. So that will do the trick. Now, hopefully, they'll fix that fairly quickly. Although it's a fairly specific bug. Maybe they won't fix it quickly, who knows. But that's how to get around it. Yeah, it sucks. I'm sorry. Right, so now we've changed the next button to a from a submit to a button. I want to get rid of it when we actually make a selection, because we don't need it. Like, we don't need to reload it because we don't want to change. So I'm going to say if this is null, we're going to do, let's capture that variable, var.next equals next. Hopefully you're still with me, or maybe you just gave up after I said you can stop there. Let's remove it. So, hide. Cool. And we want to insert a button. So what we're going to do is $form.append, and we're going to insert a new submit button. Type equals submit. Value equals read. And let's do the same character as we had before. Whoops. There we go, read, let's close that off. So now, if we select a category, we now have this read link, which submits the form. And that could then, if I select an article, click read, you'll see article equals, and we have this URL, and we could do something with that. Maybe we'll do a location redirect or whatever, but like I said, this is a fairly contrived example, so I strongly advise you don't use dropdowns for website navigation like this, because it is nasty. So that's a way to progressively enhance our select boxes. Like I said, very useful for quick prototyping, especially the load Ajax request. Otherwise, I will be following this this screencast up with another screencast about event delegation, which sounds funky but is actually very, very straightforward. So until next time, thank you for watching. If you have any comments, drop a comment on jgrouperdesigners.com. Otherwise, goodbye.